Hey guys, welcome to Wind Chaser. We are currently in the 875E, hooked up to the John Deere 2730 combination ripper. We're in field 37, just kind of plowing up this edge next to the road here. And handles the plow pretty well, going downhill on these flat parts. Get a good view of the disc here so you can see all the wings flexing and the disc buried pretty deep. Have some standing corn there. Tilling up some of this residue. Looks to be like a wheat or a barley kind of residue. Probably be the best view right here, so you can see all the flexing going on. The discs, the front set of disc wings are individual components, the rear wings are individual components, and then the there's three components on the back for the crumbler. So you guys can begin to appreciate the size of this disc. This is a single player game. I just kind of like brought our server save game over because I wanted to test and see the crops, if they wither and stuff like that. I was testing the bale issue because I didn't know what the issue was. So the working width on this is 8 meters. 7.9 point whatever, rounded up to 8. This is a cool view. I put a camera on this tillage tool so you can get a better view of center the camera on it, so it's not so at such a weird angle from the tractor cam. But we're going about 11.6, 12.1 right now. You see the nice corn in the background there. It's going to be fun to harvest all that. You can see my walking wheels, they adjust with the raise and lower, the walking tandem, so that's a nice little feature of this. And then you can, now you can really see how the raise and lower bar works. You can see how this raise and lower bar works now that I got the nice view on the camera. Then if you come up here, you can watch the whole disc assembly raise and lower. And it's just kind of neat to zoom in on the disc when it's working. I mean, not real, it's not realistic, but you know, this game is designed to kind of like admire your work and watch it work as, you know, you're doing your field work and stuff like that, so. So going to, as long as we're not going up the hill, like directly, we're kind of doing contour tillage on this hill, like you really should be doing to prevent erosion. The Challenger pulls this just fine, but if you were to go directly up these hills, you would probably really struggle. Like if you were to go straight on that hill, you'd probably knock it down to 5-6 miles an hour. You know, the thing would just be crawling at that point, which I understand that's like what you'd be going in the real world anyways with this thing, you know, 5.5 miles an hour. But this is farming simulator, and ain't no one got time for that. Oh, there's a rough spot. Anyways, I mean, it's a big disc, but still gonna take many hours of tillage to chisel plow a whole field. What we'll probably do is we'll, I really hope to get own two of these and two big tractors so we don't have to rent. But money is hard to come by on the server. I also started to kind of like revamp My 9620 RX model. Doing a lot of work on the cab, and I'm going to be giving it new textures so it matches all of my John Deere equipment. And I'm probably going to use that texture paint method to kind of like dress up some of the areas, some of the seams and stuff like that. I started doing it on this, but I just didn't really like how it was turning out. But on like a vehicle like hoods and other areas, it would definitely like look really nice at like the corners and edges. So I'll probably do that to dress up the 9RX, dress up some areas of like the tracks and some areas of tanks and some other like bare green areas. I think what I'm going to do is I'm also going to make it a road track version. I'm going to kind of like skinny up the tracks, the H tracks, and make 18-inch road track or whatever the road track dimensions are. I'll have to investigate it. I saw pictures of a 9RX in a road track configuration on a planting, like a DB120 planter. It looked really ugly, but I mean, it does exist. And then someone sent me a picture of a John Deere prototype 70-foot field cultivator, and it's still a five section. There's I forget the name of the company that makes the 80-foot cultivator. It's like seven sections, I do believe. And I mean, that's something that I would be actually rather interested in making, but I don't know. I've having bad luck with wheels on extra components, so not really sure how that would all turn out. So here's a pretty steep grade right here. Just powering up it at 9.1 miles an hour. Oh, 6.4. So this is basically a chipped, this Challenger has about 80 more horsepower than it does stock. So instead of 550 horsepower, it's about 630 horsepower is what I have it currently spec'd at in the XML. So this thing is chipped, a little bit more horsepower than the 620. Basically what I did is I just referenced the in-game 620 and determined what an extra 10 horsepower would be over that, and just kind of did the multiplier and came out with what I got. Oh, really bogging down up this portion here. Still moving along though. That's a pretty significant slope. I imagine this thing is going to look amazing in the evening time. In fact, let's just figure out what it's going to look like. So it's like 8. Oh, we got soil mod updating. Awesome, it's like 17. Thing already looks amazing, doesn't it? Gotta wait for soil mod to update so it doesn't bog everything down. It just looks amazing. It's getting a little dirty now. A little dirt on the tires. I still have to like fix the gap in my rubber between the hub. I forgot to do that, but I burnt new textures for the wheels, so they look a lot nicer now. Those are just hop back on here until our soil mod updates. It's almost updated anyways. There we go, finally updated. I like the evening lighting with this in the real day-night light mod. It just makes everything nice and crisp and really makes that color pop. Makes it nice, dark, and rich, and really does it justice, I think. Destroying weeds. I would love to see what this thing looks like in real life, like the what's before and then after. And then how actual level it makes the ground underneath, because sometimes when you look at the vertical tillage machines, or like sometimes you're running 24-inch row spacing instead of 18-inch row shanks, it's like underneath all the chaos that is the topsoil, the soil underneath, like the base layer, it's all kind of like uneven or kind of like scalloped, I guess is a really nice term to describe it. But as much as I do like my Challenger, I'm kind of really excited to get back to work on the 9RX, because right now the version I have is just, it's just not very good. I mean, the tracks and the tanks are, you know, the body parts are fine, you know, they're not that bad, but just the way the cab is, the exterior cab, I mean, the windows, it needs to be able to have windows opening, doors opening. The cab itself, the interiors, AGOs, deer stuff, so that's obviously fine and easy to script. Like when I did the in-gaming for Raphael on the 9RX, or 9RT. But I definitely think like a 9RX without the front weights and just new textures and just a save space on texture RAM, and that way I could use the body and the cab for like the 9R and the new 9R. And kind of make a John Deere pack instead of individual, so they all kind of share the same texture, so I don't have, you know, four or five mods in my folder that have the same textures, but just to save space, kind of like what I did with the combines in New Holland's. Anyways, I really like this Ripper. It's so much nicer than the 2720. As it should be. The 2720 was my first model. And this is like my 12th at this point of model built from scratch. So I kind of know what I'm doing at this point. The only thing is this buddy seat I think is a little small compared to the big command UC or whatever Challenger calls their chair. Anyways, you guys can see how hilly this field actually is now. It used to be really flat, one big field, but now you can see the difference in elevation between this high point and low points, and Oh, this is a pretty cool field, actually. It's kind of like right in the middle. Middle of all the action. 37's also, I keep saying that, it's just because really good views over there, but this field's a good one. Always stuff to look at. A lot of different changes in elevation. Makes implements, you know, do their thing when it comes to flexing. But those shanks are buried. These are 26-inch discs, by the way. That's what they're scaled at. The disc on my 26-23, those are 24-inch discs. So these discs are actually 2 inches in diameter larger than what's on my 23. Nice quiet interior. Okay, so just kind of want a nice quiet cab ride for the day. Sometimes I like to hear the loud noise and just kind of like watch the implements at work. Sometimes I'm like listening to a movie or like listening to a lecture or listening to music or doing something else. So I like the in-cab quiet, the quiet in-cab view. Sometimes, so. This is gonna be fun going up this hill again. It's pretty steep here. Anyways guys, probably gonna call it a video here. I just wanted to test out this 26 or this 2730 on a little bit more. more aggressive fields here on Windchaser for once. So thanks for watching.